Norway rats actually arrived in the US in the 1770s from Central Asia. It is the most widely distributed rat species in the US. Norway rats will eat just about
Sorry, you know,
anything,
there's probably
people's
more.
foods, and any available natural foods. Norway rats are very nimble and can easily climb to get their food. This makes them hard to manage. Rats construct burrowing nests. They include passageways, runways, and chambers. Usually, they are constructed alongside building foundations or underneath building slabs. To control rats, you need a coordinated approach using integrated pest management. The first step was to clean up the dumpsters and remove their food source. Use exterior trash receptacles with tight-fitting or spring-loaded lids. Place the trash receptacles far away from
Look at this guy.
buildings and empty once a day if possible.
Oh, over there. He's gone.
You can also remove debris, clutter, and ground cover to prevent and discourage rodent travel ways and rat burrowing. A second IPM method is to use baited snap traps. The most important tool is good trap placement. Place traps where there is lots of activity. Use tamper-resistant bait stations with a protein lure. Make sure that the traps are weighted. A third step you can use is biological control. In this case, a rat terrier was brought in to catch the rats. Rat terriers were brought to the US by British migrants. They were bred for speed and used to control rodents and to hunt small game. So, what's good about rats? Norway rats disperse seeds when they eat them and poop them out in new places. This helps plants spread. Rats also help plants grow by aerating soil. This means that they put oxygen into the soil when they dig. This can make plants healthier in some areas. Nevertheless, having rats in an urban area is generally not a good idea.